Hey YouTube, Fireflash here, coming at you with a Transformers haul video. As we near the end of March, we have more Japanese releases. This time we have the Japanese version of the 2015 series, Robots in Disguise, otherwise known as Transformers Adventures in Japan. And this is the VS pack, Bumblebee versus Steeljaw. So you get the Warrior or Deluxe class Bumblebee with Steeljaw in a two pack. Worked out to be slightly cheaper than buying the two singles. And really, really nice box. Nice artwork all around the side. Lots of Japanese on it that I can't read. And really looking forward to opening these up and playing around with them. Not 100% sure on the future of this line. At the moment, this is the only Warrior class Decepticon. No Voyagers yet, and all other known Decepticons are one step changes. I'm not a big fan of one step changes. I want my Transformers to transform properly, but hopefully down the line they stop releasing lots of Autobots and add in some more Decepticons from the show. So that's the first one. Next up we have Grimlock here. So he's a Warrior class or Deluxe. Now on the show he is slightly larger than the other guys, but in toy form he's about the same size. Nice back of the box. Now they did release, as I knock off a car, in Japan, two animated characters to make a Dinobot trio. I did not get those, but that is Grimlock. We have Strongarm here, who is the rookie cadet by the book, but also a female, so good to get another female Transformer. Yeah, very nice. Bit more extra detailing on all of these than the American versions. Not accurate at all to the cartoon, missing a whole lot of the like Energon details that they have in the cartoon. And just some overall general oddness. They all have this scan image on here. American version unlocks a game on the American version of the game. In Japan does very similar things. Japanese versions of those symbols are even larger than the American ones. Just wish they had normal Tampograph symbols on them, but what can you do? So next up we have some additions to the line. Transformers Adventure seems to be a little bit of a catch-all series. There are a whole lot of extra toys added in to fill out the ranks, as well as some toys that haven't been released yet in Japan. So this is Beast Hunter's Knockout from Transformers Prime. So it's a version with the Crocodile Claw, otherwise known as Crocout. Absolutely love the name of this guy, Bloody Knockout. That is a fantastic name for this guy. Love the colour scheme. Haven't played with this toy before. Didn't get into Transformers Prime at all. The differences between the first edition and the regular characters was just a bit too big for me, and also Japan went the odd route with the armed Micron add-ons, and I just didn't feel it at all. Plus I was unemployed at the time, so that didn't help. And next up, my final pickup, Dreadwing, again another Beast Hunters Prime fill-in. Just love the decoration on this compared to the American version though. Looks very, very nice. You know, I do wish there were some Voyagers to break up all these bots being the same size, but you know, it is what it is. And hopefully, as I said, the line extends in the next year or so with more actual on-screen characters and not just a whole lot of random toys or one-step, you know, easy Transformers. Because I'm a big boy and I know how to transform my toys. So that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know if you are picking up any of the American or indeed the Japanese versions of these toys. Bye for now. And there we are, YouTube. Just a quick look at these toys all out of their packaging. One interesting note is that every single one of these had this wee plastic piece covering the real sticker. So obviously Japan, they don't want them photographing or using the sticker on the toy to activate something if before you buy the toy. So I thought that was kind of interesting. And that's it, guys. Take care and bye for now.